Good afternoon, myself Sneha, I am from Mechanical Department. Today I am going to continue the previous PPT with Flexible Manufacturing System. Flexible Manufacturing System is a 15-minute topic. In this, FMS was first conceptualized for machining and it required the prior development of engine. So before starting an FMS system in any of the company related to CAD, first we need to have the NC, numerical control development is required. Then only we can able to implement for CNC machines, computer numerical control, but not for the conventional and traditional machines. This concept is credited to David Williamson, a British engineer during the mid of 1960s. So after late 1960s, the first FMS machining system, that is everything is available at one point regarding drafting, regarding manufacturing and sheet metal processing, inspection techniques, everything will be seen here in FMS system. So next, Germany implemented its first FMS, that is Flexible Manufacturing System, in 1969, incorporated with University of Stuttgart. Next, Russia and Japan followed by it in 1972. So this is the layout of an FMS system. Here we will be having workstation number 1, number 2 and 3. So this is the tool carrying the workstation within the CNC machine, and input and output will be done from here. So in between you are having a AGV system, that is the material handling system arrangement. AGV, automated guided vehicles, will be moving over the belt drives, over the conveyor belt drives or screw conveyor, any of the drives. And the left side will be having the raw material storage, and then you will be having the loading and unloading station. At one point loading will be done, and at the same point only after finishing the machining operation, the unloading of that particular job will be done here. Next, everything will be controlled by a computer control. So all the input, output, or the loading, unloading, or the AGV moving over the conveyor, and the working of CNC machine by the machine tools, that is tool, everything is operated by a single computer system, by a single computer control system. Here you will be having raw material and storage roller conveyors. Okay, storage, raw material, storage of conveyors is taking place. Here how it works, let us see the working condition. So from here, loading of the material will be done to the conveyor, and then from there the AGV moving, like you can also have robots as an AGV. Robots also plays an AGV. So from there, that AGV will carry the work where it has to go. First operation is done over CNC, or 1 or 2 or 3. First operation will be done, and then again the AGV will be removing the product from that CNC machine, and then it will be moving to the next station. Like that, after completing all the operations, then the unloading will be done from here. So these layouts are also having many types. Let us see in the next slides of that. Why FMS? Why we are introducing an FMS system, FMS in manufacturing system? First one is external changes, such as change in product design and the product system. You can easily change any of the product design or the production system. If you want to change the route sheet by using that computer control, you can change it. And then after changing, the finishing of operation is done, job is out, and there itself you can do in the same computer the inspection techniques. So you will be having different inspection techniques, and you can also see the quality of that particular final product. After undergoing any heat treatment process, the material properties changes. So that material properties can be changed, like physical properties will be changing in ductility, brittleness and all. After giving certain heat to the job, this will be changing. So you can see that changes in the same computer itself. And then if you want to do any sheet metal processing for the raw material, and then that metal process sheet is given to the machining operation, like that everything will be done at one point. That is the advantage of using FMS. So optimizing the manufacturing cycle time, you can reduce the cycle time. At one point you are having all the operations, so you can reduce the manufacturing time from one shop floor to another shop floor. If you move the product, it also has the carrying thing, that is automated guided vehicle should be there from one point to another point. Like that, many of the time lapse will be reduced. Next, reduction in the production cost. Production cost also be affecting, that can be reduced by FMS, and overcoming the internal changes like breakdowns. Breakdown, if anything has happened, very less chances will be there in FMS. So that breakdown things also you can able to sort out at that point only. Yes, sort out at that point only. Next one is why make, what makes it flexible? Why we are making it flexible? It can adopt any type of operation at one point. Any type of operation can be adopted by the work material. So three capabilities that manufacturing system must possess to be flexible. First one is ability to identify, distinguish among different parts, types, process by the system. Each part, you will be having a cylindrical section, you will be having a square billet, like a different sections, it can be able to adopt the particular operation. So that flexibility can be attained within the manufacturing system, that is in CNCs itself. There we can attain that. And quick changeover of the operating instructions. Any instruction is changed within the system, at that point only you can change the instruction and you can change that particular operating thing. So that can also be adopted here. Quick changeover of the physical setup. If you want to change any physical setup, it can be accommodated there. So if you do that individually, how much time lapse is there, how much area occupance is there, like that, many drawbacks are there. So such drawbacks can be eradicated by using this FMS system. Next, classification based on the number of workstations, it is being classified as single machine cell, flexible manufacturing cell, and flexible manufacturing system. In single machine cell, here if you see, you will be having one CNC machine. So only one machine, number of machine tools are there here within the turret. So that each tool will be coming across the workpiece and do the operation, and it will be moving with the next tool. So here one CNC is being controlled here by one computer control. So the movement of the workpiece from the stationary idle point over the pallet to the working condition, that is being done by the system itself. And here you are having the pallet holder. When it is in idle time, it will be held in this pallet, and then it is moving over the shuttle truck, and then emptying the pallet after finishing the workpiece, the unloading will be done here. So like this, only one machine is being controlled here in single machine cell. A single machine cell consists of one CNC machining center combined with a part storage system for unattended operation. Next, completed parts are periodically unloaded at this point. Next one is flexible manufacturing cell. A flexible manufacturing cell here, two and more. There are only one workstation here, two and more workstations, and remaining arrangement will be same. Here in flexible manufacturing system, there are number of controls. Computer controls are there. It is being connected with the electronic devices to the machines, that is workstations, to the workstations. So like that, you, at one point you can have many monitoring is done by these computer controls of number of workstations. A flexible manufacturing system have four or more possible workstations connected mechanically by a common part handling system, and electronically by the distributed computer system. Here are the basic components of an FMS. So it consists of workstations, which I have already told you, automated material handling and storage system. You can have a pick and place robot as one of the example here. Handling storage system, you will be having a conveyor there. Next, computer control system, which monitors have the substations like loading and unloading station, machining stations and other processing like sheet metal processing like that. And assembly station also you can have there. Assembly stations. Here metal handling system, automated fork lifting and rail travel. So this is the rail travel, this is the handling system, metal handling system from one CNC machine to the other CNC machine. You can see the pictures of it. You can see the pictures of it here. You can also store and you can also be mobile. Moving of the workpiece from one station to another station is done with this automated fork lifting and rail travel. Next, computer control program, that is the CNC programming will be done, material moving will be done at the same time after completion of the loaded part where you have to move either for inspection or for assembly part. That will be choosing there and then it will be moving and which part should be assembled at which sequence, that also be stored within the program of the program within the computer control. So yeah, that is the work of this computer control. Next, here if you see here, it is a picture of a line signal flexible manufacturing system. It is in one aligned station and there where automated guided vehicles are there, machine centers where it is there. Next you have the control room and you have the coordinate measuring machines. See, CMM is being used here. CMM machines are being used and storage station is here and tool center. Next, fixture bed station, loading and unloading station. At one point you can get everything within the manufacturing system. So this is one of the best thing to adopt by the manufacturing companies. So in few of the companies it is being used and later it must be adopted according to the manufacturing item which job you are able to manage. Through conveyors there you can use here. According to the final product, the size of the system will be changing. So if it is adoptable, you can go with that. So many of the companies are still trying to adopt this flexible management system because the robots are being replaced by the human intervenants. Okay, so where we can also have reduction in the job opportunities for the people because the robot itself doing everything there. So next machine, A5 machines, you are having different machines. I am just showing the picture of it, whatever I have told that one. Here you are having number of machines and how it is being operated there by this computer control and all, and then it is how it is moving from one point to point, how the AGVs are placed here, and from loading and unloading how it is moving there. Here the conveyor belts, everything it is being shown. Here you are having the computer control. Next, computer control. Human resources, typically what it performs, human resources, why we are using here for switching on of the machine and switching off at the same time, loading of raw material and unloading of the assembled part and then changing and setting tools. If you are mostly we'll be using turret types. If any further problem is also there, you can use there. And if any program change within the CNC, that also be done by this human resources and equipment maintenance and repair. This is the main part. Equipment maintenance should be done by this by this human resources only. And NC part program, if you want to change or replace any of the dimensions and all, he will be handled. Next, layout of FMS. So these are the different layouts, progressive, or it is also called as inline layout. Next, new ladder layout, open field layout, and robot center layout. These are the five layouts. In this, we will be seeing the progressive layout. In progressive layout, you are having the starting point where the work part is being loaded, and at the other point, the work part is being unloaded. In between, the workflow, red dots are the workflow for different machine stations, different workstations. So the work part will be moving to the first station and then it is going to the next. The reverse flow of the work will not take place here, only in one direction. Only one direction. One direction workflow will be taking place. So by this, I will just cut. in the next video.